Behold the power of lemon pepper wings. Lou Will, busted. Rashawn Holmes, busted. Dame Lillard, birthday. Yes, they are irresistible, but now everyone hates Lou Will.
As soon as news broke that he went to a strip club while outside the bubble, people freaked out. Lou Will leaving the bubble to go to a party is inexcusable and selfish AF, absolutely disgusting. Lost so much respect for Lou Will. Selfish and irresponsible. Okay, people need to settle down. These people say that Lou Will is risking the entire league by going to this club outside the bubble. In this video, I'll explain why those people are dead wrong, how the NBA actually agrees with me, and the actual problem that the Clippers have right now that no one is mentioning. Hey, it's Casey. Welcome to another week of AM Hoops. Hit subscribe and hit notification bells. It really helps out the channel. We have been coming out with 5 videos per week ever since this season started. And the season just is never ending. We just had an unexpected 4-month off season. We are finally getting games back this week and we are not slowing down here on the channel. Quickly, before we get to this, a 30-second recap of the situation. The NBA will allow you to leave the Orlando bubble for an excused absence. Lou Williams had a funeral to attend in his hometown of Atlanta. As long as he's tested every day he's out and negative, it's just a 4-day quarantine when he returns. Lou tested negative every day. He posted this picture. Everything was by the book. Then bam, rapper Jack Harlow posted this pic of him and Lou at an Atlanta strip club called Magic City. He quickly deleted it because he realized he snitched. Harlow backtracked and said, "Oh, that was an old pic. I was just reminiscing because I miss him." Nice try, Jack. That is actually the mask Lou got in the bubble from the NBA. Busted. Lou fessed up saying he was just there to pick up food. After an investigation, the NBA announced his punishment is a 10-day quarantine. That means the Clippers will miss their 6th man of the year for 2 seeding games. That sucks. And yeah, it would have sucked even more if Lou had gotten the virus, infected his teammates, but settle down. That is the risk the NBA takes when they allow excused absences. People are overreacting because if Lou was just there to pick up food, that's expected, honestly, when a player leaves the bubble. I mean, Zion Williamson was out for a week. Austin Rivers is gone right now. You don't think that they have done something as or more dangerous than just go pick up food. You're just freaked out because it was a strip club. Apparently in Atlanta, this is how they do it. Some strip clubs have great food. This just so happens to be Lou Will's favorite place. He went in there with a mask to pick up chicken wings and someone snapped a picture. If you take the word strip club out of it, people have a different reaction, I guarantee you. Now, I do think the NBA had to do something because yes, it does look bad, but they gave him a slap on the wrist. The NBA knows, like me, this is not a big deal. I believe Lou Will that he was there to pick up food and nothing else. He has said in interviews, it's his favorite food in his hometown of Atlanta. The literal menu has wings named after Lou Will. The NBA believes him too. All they did was give him a 10-day quarantine. An unexcused absence is 14 days. Literally, Rashawn Holmes stepped over the bubble line to pick up food. He got 10 days. If the NBA agreed with all these wackos overreacting, Lou Will would have gotten more than 10 days. But instead, the NBA is using common sense. Picking up that food was no more dangerous than a funeral or a reception after a funeral. Look, the bottom line is this. Here are the facts. Lou Will left the bubble for 2 days. He tested negative both days. Now he is back in the bubble, still negative. Yes, he picked up some food while he was out. A rapper happened to take a selfie of the two of them while that happened. Does he deserve some punishment? Okay, I guess. But the people saying that he is the most selfish NBA player who's ever lived are overreacting. We really need to get to the actual problem that the Clippers are dealing with. But first, I have to address what some people in the comments are gonna say. I know people will say there are other pictures. Photos have come out of Lou Will, let's say, talking with a worker at the strip club. We have no idea when these photos were taken. The dude is there all the time, apparently, in the off season. Other people are gonna say he should have done curbside pickup or have someone else pick up the food for him. I agree. But people are still overreacting. Lou defended himself. Ask any of my teammates, what's my favorite restaurant in Atlanta? Ain't nobody partying. Then this guy responds he's selfish? People need to be marching against you? What? For someone to compare Lou Will picking up food to social injustice and the protests is ridiculous. This overreaction is insane. But I know the biggest argument will be the slippery slope argument. It's what people use when they don't have anything smart to say. What if Lou got infected at the club, then he infected his teammates, then they infected the entire bubble and the whole league got shut down? Sounds scary, right? That logic ignores the fact that the league has a system in place for excused absences. Lou tests negative while he's out, goes through the 4-day quarantine, then goes back to his team. If that didn't work, then this whole bubble thing wouldn't work. The slippery slope is used because people don't actually have a case against Lou. They just don't like the words strip club. No, if I was a Clippers fan, I would not be concerned with that. They have an actual issue that is much bigger than Lou Williams' chicken wings. Their big issue is having so many guys out. In their second scrimmage, they literally had to run a lot of third-string guys. They are missing Patrick Beverley, Montrezl Harrell, Lou Williams, Ivica Zubac, and Landry Shamet for that game. And this team specifically cannot afford that. They've missed valuable time to build chemistry. No team in the bubble needed this time more than the Clippers. The Clippers have been my pick to win the title all along, but this seriously concerns me. And it concerns Doc Rivers, too.
Today, we have a practice and a lot of our guys aren't here. So that's never healthy for your team, especially a team that really hasn't been together. I mean, we're a new team. We had Kawhi and PG miss training camp. PG missed the first 16 games, then Kawhi missed games, and Lou, this year so far, we really have not caught a great break as far as being able to work together.
Exactly. The Clippers may have more depth and talent than everyone else, but they can't afford to miss any time on the floor together. Doc also said there are a lot of guys who just don't remember the plays because they haven't run his system long enough. The NBA isn't just roll the ball out, the most talented team wins. The Clippers are behind teams like the Lakers, the Bucks, and the Rockets right now in terms of chemistry. I look at other teams that are mostly intact, like the Celtics, or yes, the Toronto Raptors. The Lakers are missing Avery Bradley. They are using this time to work in their new guys. If the Clippers lose seeding games, I'm not saying it's going to ruin a lot of people's day. There aren't exactly a lot of Clippers fans. But it could ruin the most exciting thing about these playoffs, a Clippers-Lakers Western Conference final. Outside of the team you root for, most people want to see that matchup for all the talent on the floor. Right now, the Clips only have a 1.5 game lead on the 3 seed and a 3 game lead on the 4 seed. All they have to do is mess around and lose some of these seeding games, slip to the 4, and they're in the same bracket as the Lakers. We could easily have a Lakers-Clippers conference semifinals. Not exactly the same thing. That also gives another team like the Rockets or the Mavericks an easier road to the conference finals. Right now, Ivica Zubac and Landry Shamet just arrived in the bubble. Pat Beverley just got back. We still don't know about Montrez. And Lou Will is in 10 days of quarantine starting Saturday. If chemistry and game shape are an issue, that's a good thing for every team on the Clippers' schedule. They will face the Lakers first, then the Pelicans, who want that 8 seed, eventually Portland, who's in that 8 seed race too, the Mavericks are trying to move up, the Nuggets could pass the Clips for the 2 seed. Best case scenario, the Clippers will have their full bubble squad for these 6 games before the playoffs start. If that's not enough time to get set, that is really good news for whoever they face in the first round of the playoffs. I know you don't want to hear this, but we're starting to get into asterisk territory here. I mean, one of the best teams might be missing key players, and that would mess with the integrity of the bracket in the West. What's insane is the virus isn't actually taking guys out. It's just the threat of the virus. One thing we have learned, the NBA will quarantine you for double-digit days for a minor violation, which is kind of funny during scrimmages, but I really hope guys, including Lou Will, have learned their lesson. People are focused on the wrong thing, and I'm not surprised. I mean, Lou Williams, chicken wings, rapper, strip club, that is gonna grab a lot of headlines and not just missing a lot of guys in the bubble. But you could hear it in Doc Rivers' voice. He is seriously concerned. I think people are overreacting to that one thing, and they should be concerned about the real issue for the Clippers. Support AM Hoops and click subscribe. Don't miss a daily NBA video.